dreams, wrinkle silk on my sheets. I don't see nobody but you.
Boy, you got me hooked on to something. Who could say that they saw us? Come and tell me, do you feel the love? Spend the summer of a lifetime with me. Let me take you to the
today, we are going to see the effectiveness of phytoremediation plants in controlling soil pollution. What is phytoremediation? Phytoremediation is one of the treatment methods which uses plants for the purpose of degradation, extraction or elimination of pollute substance from soil and water.
To begin the experiment, let us see the problem statement, which is: are phytoremediation plants effective in controlling the soil pollution? Next, our aim is to study the effectiveness of phytoremediation plant in controlling soil contamination. Hypothesis: the root of water spinach can absorb nutrients such as ammonia in soil.
There are three variables in this experiment. The first one, manipulated variable, which is the presence of water spinach. The second one, responding variable, reading of ammonia in the soil at the end of the experiment. And the last one is constant variable, which is the mass of the soil.
For materials, we are using water spinach, 5 kg of food waste, 50 ml of 2M potassium chloride solution, plastic container, 5 kg of black soil, distilled water, and ammonia test kit. While for apparatus, we only need 100 ml beaker and oven. And how to differentiate between materials and apparatus is, materials are substances that we have to throw away after we use it. Now let's move to the procedure. Firstly, flatten a thin layer of 5 kg of black soil on a plastic sheet. Then dry it using an oven. Next, put 2.5 kg of black soil in a plastic container and label it as container A. Put the remaining 2.5 kg of black soil in another plastic container and label it as container B. To determine the ammonia content of the soil in container A and B, put 7 g of black soil from containers A and B in different conical flasks. Mix 50 ml of 2M potassium chloride solution into 2 different conical flasks and shake them. Filter the mixture into a 100 ml beaker. Then, put 20 ml of distilled water into the filtrate. Determine the concentration of ammonia in the filtrate using an ammonia test kit. Transfer 20 water spinach stalks into container A, while container B is left without a water spinach plant as a control set. Don't forget to place containers A and B in a warm but sheltered area. Also, put equal amount of water every day into containers A and B for 2 weeks. After 2 weeks, we are going to repeat step 4 to test for ammonia content in containers A and B. Then, record the final reading of ammonia in a table. So this is the result of the experiment. As you can see, at the beginning of experiment, both glass container A and B have the same reading of ammonia. But at the end of the experiment, glass container A, which contain water spinach, have lower reading of ammonia, while glass container B, which is left without water spinach, remain same.
Discussion and conclusion. Discussion. Number 1. Why must the soil sample be dried before the experiment begins? It must be dried to remove the water content and get an accurate mass of dry soil. Number 2, what is the significance of using water spinach in this experiment? Water spinach can treat soil by absorbing the ammonia from the soil. So, that's why the container A, which contains water spinach, have lower ammonia reading compared to container B, which is left without water spinach. Conclusion, is the hypothesis accepted? Suggest a suitable conclusion. Yes, the roots of water spinach can absorb nutrients such as ammonia in soil.